Thank you very much. Today I talk about energy system platform using lightweight weaving. So I'm Kazuaki Tanaka from Kyushu Institute of Technology, Japan. So today's topic is this. So do you know, of course you know, do you know the embedded system? So embedded system, that is not general purpose computer, not PC, but computer system designed to specific functions. So for instance, mobile phone or home appliances or some hardware controllers and so on. But in such area, when restrictions exist, software productivity. So recently, the such embedded system is line of the code is larger and larger. So that is a problem to implement. And resources, of course, memory and processor powers, and cost and size. Some small devices are very small, so such implementation hardware is a compaction to such small size. So that is the problem. And also sometimes heat, some problem is sometimes occurs. That is a restriction and resource limitation. And reliability. So some embedded system is a very long-term execution. Sometimes MTBF equals to production lifetime. Some embedded system is so. So that is very hard or toughness is required. And also, how to develop embedded system software. So usually, you use a cross-compiling environment. That is very difficult and complex environment. So cross-compiling means compile one original source into another target source. For instance, we develop in other computer, sometimes Mac OS, but target devices are very small devices, mobile phone and so on. So how to test the execution code? Of course, my Macintosh don't execute such target device, binary code. So how to test, that is also a problem. So our mission is efficiency of the Ruby. Ruby have a high productivity or easy to write and so on. Of course you know. So we want to apply such efficiency for embedded system development. And we want to provide a development platform for embedded system development. So this is our project team. Of course, Max is a member of our project. And many researchers and advisors is researching about developing about this lightweight Ruby. So Ruby is of course you know Ruby is this. Sorry. So problems in embedded system. So I thought so the complexity of the software is a problem, and trade off between cost, quality and delivery time. So this is a very complex system is necessary. So that is a problem, also a problem. And in such area, high development efficiency is required, desired. So we develop, now we're developing a lightweight Ruby. So what is lightweight? Lightweight is, of course, lightweight. So the first is the standard is specification is lightweight. So only on this Japan industry standard, only on ISO. Maybe soon ISO standard is open. Maybe. And demand resources are lightweight. So memory or processor power or and so on. So our idea is very simple. Ruby compiler and Ruby VM. So separate compiler and virtual machine. So this is something like Java. Java is a Java compiler and bytecode is executed on such a machine. That's the same situation. But Ruby is a dynamically typing, dynamic typing language. So in this compiler and Ruby VM keeps the dynamically situation, dynamic typing after compilation, and mixing, dynamic binding is also existing. This is a development flow of an embedded system. So traditional embedded system is a C or C++ implementation, but our mission is a Ruby implementation into embedded systems. So we implement a Ruby code on development environment and compile to bytecode. Bytecode is a binary code. And then download to the target device. So you can execute the Ruby code in embedded system or target device. But interesting is this. So this lightweight Ruby bytecode is device independent. So binary, of course binary, but device independent. So we can execute this bytecode on development environment. So we can execute such binary file, binary codes in our development environment. So we can test this bytecode on desktop PC development environment. Then we can test. And then same bytecode is to be transferred, download to the target device, then execute. Of course, code is the same, exactly the same. So we can test, and then we can download and execute on target device. That is the key point of this lightweight Ruby. So this is a compile and download to a virtual machine, and then execute. So interesting point or more technological focus on technological point is using mixing technology. As you know, mixing technology is a very important technology on Ruby, of Ruby. So mixing, we are now using mixing technology for binding libraries. So each target device has controlling some devices interfaces. Sometimes digital devices, or sometimes network devices, or device-dependent library is necessary. So such library is implemented in target device, of course, library, other library. And binary code, bytecode is downloaded to virtual machine. Then mixing, so dynamically binding. Then this bytecode can be executed on virtual machine. So no link, no decompile, and so that is not necessary. So only download to the target device, then we can execute the bytecode directly. So this is the point. No cross compile. Cross compile is very difficult and very complex. So I don't want to cross compile. So cross compile, and no library linkage. So library linkage in the dynamically. So not linkage phase. No linkage phase. So dynamic mixing is the key point. So now the lightweight is evaluating phase. So I cannot tell a detail of estimating of the execution resources, but roughly to say, this is the execution resources. So C Ruby, the traditional Ruby, is on PC, and of course, operating system is necessary, and of course, file system is necessary. So that is the current Ruby, C Ruby or MRI. But lightweight Ruby is a compiler, and virtual machine is separated. So compiler is only on desktop PC, so that is no problem. So many resources, that is no problem. But Ruby virtual machine is only on few megabytes. Few is 1 or 2 megabytes, maybe. Not estimated, but maybe few megabytes. And megabyte memory, and non-OS environment is also available, non-OS. So very small devices, such as refrigerator or microwave oven or such small devices that they are non-OS environment is also okay, and operating system environment. So Windows or Linux or such environment is also okay, and real-time operating system. So in industrial area, so real-time OS is used. So such area, is, operating system is also okay. And file system, our some file system. File system is not necessary. Of course, file system is exists then, file load and dynamic binding is very smooth, but non-file system is also okay. So binary bytecode is, of course, binary. That is like a C array is enough. So C array pointer is handled to pass to such a loading function, then dynamic loading and so on. So we can use a non-file system environment also. So this is a virtual machine specification like this. Of course, contains a block and program number we can use. So dynamically, this is really dynamic. So we can use dynamic binding and dynamic loading as also. Overriding is also okay. And application area that we are now supporting to application area is this real-time operating system area, industrial area. And Ruby chip is a very small device. So evaluation application is like this. So Toshiba or IAJ is a networking service provider in Japan. And vending machines or sometimes very interesting area. So DNS sequencer is an interesting application area. We are now evaluating such areas. Ruby is available or not available. Now evaluating. And application sample is this. This is protected by Toshiba. Toshiba product this FPGA processor, and the main purpose is how to implement hardware coding of Ruby, lightweight Ruby. And developing interfaces, network interfaces or memory interfaces or sound interfaces, USB, several interfaces now, library is now developing. And this is a YASCAR manipulator. So real-time operating system is running on this robot. And how to control this robot by Ruby. That is something interesting application. So we are now applying this area. And this area. So now we are planning compiler and Ruby virtual machine is distributed as an open source software on April, maybe April, every next April. So this project ends March, next March. So we now preparing the website and then distributed as an open source software. And class library design is now progressing because currently C Ruby does not have a hardware controlling libraries. So we don't have any such class hierarchy. So I am now designing such class hierarchy and class libraries and also evaluating. So now so please wait till next day, please. Then we can provide the open source software. Thank you very much.